What do you do if you've been told you have a low AMH? Can you conceive with a low AMH? Welcome to Fertile Minds. I'm Dr. Manny Mangat, and I am a fertility specialist with IVF Australia. Today, I thought I will explain a little bit about AMH, which I'm sure most of you have heard about. AMH is a blood test that stands for anti-Müllerian hormone, and it's often recommended to check your baseline egg reserve or fertility when it comes to planning what you're going to do with your future or prior to starting treatment. Now, we are born as women with all the eggs we're ever going to have. So we come out of our mothers with all our eggs, and they live in primordial cells in our ovaries. We are then genetically programmed to recruit a certain number of those follicles each month. And until puberty, there is no signal or communication between our brain and the ovary to tell those follicles what to do. So each month they are trees or die, and the following month the recruitment starts again. Now, we're born with about a million eggs, but by the time we go through puberty, we only have about 350,000 eggs left. So we've lost those eggs at an alarming rate even before we were ever ready to use them. So what changes at puberty is that your pituitary or your brain matures to communicate with those primordial cells that have been genetically brought out of resting. They then become preantral cells, and that is what releases the hormone AMH. So it doesn't tell you the number of eggs you have left, but it gives you an indication of a hormone level, and therefore it plots you on a graph based on your age as to whether it is low, normal, or high. Now, it's very important to remember that the AMH level is a quantitation and it does not reflect egg quality. The primary determinant of egg quality is our female age. Because those eggs have been in our ovaries our whole lives, they are susceptible to reactive oxidative stress and byproducts of our cellular metabolism, and therefore slowly age over time. So it is important to note that the AMH level is just an indication of quantity and where you sit for your age. So if you have been told you have a low AMH, first of all, that does not mean you are infertile. You definitely can still go ahead and fall pregnant. Remember, each month, your genetic programming brings up a certain number of follicles. Your AMH then communicates with your brain to guide it as to how many follicles to then choose for the month. That group of follicles is what's called your antral follicle count. And that is what will be hormone sensitive. And that is what your body can manipulate to ovulation, or we can manipulate and rescue in an IVF cycle. So naturally, one of these follicles will grow and win the hormone race to dominance and then ovulate, which gives you the chance of conception. So as long as you have a group of follicles recruited and still have eggs present, and your hormones are working in the right order to then cause an LH surge and ovulation, you definitely still have a chance to catch that egg and fall pregnant. Therefore, the AMH level, I find, is more important for patients of mine who come and see me who may want to delay childbearing or who may want to look at freezing their eggs. Therefore, the AMH level gives me an idea of planning. So I know if the level is low, we should probably go ahead and do something now, or we should progress to treatment sooner. Or if we are doing treatment, it gives me a guide on the dose of medication to use. However, that AMH level itself, as I would like to reiterate, does not mean you cannot fall pregnant on your own, as long as you are ovulating and having regular menstrual cycles. Now, if you have been told, however, that you have a low AMH, obviously that can cause concern. Therefore, please feel free to make an appointment to speak to a fertility specialist about your individual situation. Now, if you haven't started trying and you decided to check your AMH. It's come back low, and now you think you might start planning a family sooner rather than later. I would still recommend that you track your ovulation, know your cycle, time your intercourse at the right time, and if things don't happen after 3 or 6 timed attempts, you should then see a fertility specialist so that we can then guide you on the next steps, depending on the levels, on how to best achieve a positive outcome. I hope that has shed some light on AMH and what it means. The most important thing is to stay healthy and keep those eggs in the best condition you can. Please feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions. And don't forget to hit subscribe if you want to stay up to date. Thank you.